السلام عليكم، أهلا بكم في another discussion of the most important definitions regarding the 18th century Britain. تعالوا نشوف مع بعض أهم التعريفات المهمة لبعض المصطلحات والشخصيات المهمة في بريطانيا في القرن 18. The first one is the Tory. The Tory is a member, actually was a member of political party in Great Britain that has been known as the Conservative Party. يعني كان معروف إن هو الحزب المحافظ Conservative Party since 1832 and it was the opposition party to the Whigs. وكان اللي هو الفريق المعارض أو الحزب المعارض للويجز. A Tory is a supporter of traditional political and social institutions against the forces of reform, ضد أو في مقابل قوات التغيير والإصلاح. A political conservative. تمام؟ طيب. Number two, the Whig. The Whig is a member of the British Reforming and Constitutional Party, الحزب الدستوري والإصلاحي, that sought the supremacy of Parliament and was eventually succeeded in the 19th century by the Liberal Party. The Whig is a supporter of the American side during the War of American Independence. Okay. Number three, class. إيه هو تعريف كلمة class? A class is a set or a category of things having some property or attribute in common and differentiated from others by kind, type, or quality. فنقدر نقول إن الكلاس هو a system of ordering society، طبعا مش بشكل منظم أو ممنهج، هو بشكل natural ordering society whereby people are divided into sets based on perceived social or economic status. Okay. Number three, definition of free trade. التجارة الحرة. Free trade is an international trade left to its natural course without tariffs, quotas or other restrictions. وهي عبارة عن a policy by which a government does not discriminate against imports or interfere with exports by applying tariffs to imports or subsidies to exports. A free trade policy doesn't necessarily imply, however, that a country abandons all control and taxation of imports and exports. Okay? Type number five, industrial revolution. Industrial revolution in modern history is the process of a change from an agrarian and handicraft economy to one dominated by industry and machine manufacturing. هي عملية تحول للدولة من الشكل الزراعي والحرفي لشكل صناعي ومميكن. These technological changes introduced novel ways of working and living and fundamentally transformed society. This process began in Britain in the 18th century and from there spread to other parts of the world. Okay? Number six, consumerism is the propensity to consume and keep consuming. It's the drive to buy and own more stuff, الاستهلاكية, and to define one's identity through what they own. بعرف أو بأخذ هوية من كم الأشياء اللي أنا بأمتلكها. Number seven, radicalism. Radicalism in political science is the belief that society needs to be changed. عملية التغيير الملحة. And that these changes are only possible through revolutionary means. مش بسبل تقليدية. هذا التغيير ممكن فقط عن طريق الوسائل الثورية اللي بتعمل تغيير جذري في المجتمع. Number eight, عندنا شخصية سياسية اسمها Arthur Wellesley. هو the first Duke of Wellington, served as the British Prime Minister twice. He also served as the Governor of Missouri and won the Battle of Assaya. He led the Hundred Days War. كان هو قائد لحرب اللي احنا بنسميها the Hundred Days War along with the Prussian army. He won the Battle of Waterloo وكمان defeating Napoleon. Okay. Number nine, William Wilberforce. He was an independent MP from Yorkshire and was a champion for the British anti-slavery movement and made a significant contribution to the passage of the 1807 Slave Trade Act and the 1833 Slavery Abolition Act. He supported missionaries in India, founded the Church Mission Society, and was against animal cruelty. الشخصية الأخيرة عندنا هو توماس أتوود. He was a British banker, economist, political campaigner. Thomas Atwood is best remembered as the leader in the electoral reform movement. He founded the Birmingham Political Union and emerged as a prominent figure of the Birmingham School. And during the public campaign for Great Reform Act of 1832, after the act was passed, Atwood and Joshua Schofield became the first two members of the parliament for Birmingham.